We are a medical device startup based out of India.
Yeah.
We are on a mission to cut down infant mortality and morbidity in the developing world.
The NemoCare, the sensor, what does it detect? What does it monitor?
Sure. So the device is a wearable device that goes on the foot of the baby. And so this is a device that tracks close to 6 vital parameters of the newborn. Mm-hmm. It goes on the foot of the newborn and tracks these vitals. These are the vitals that the doctor really looks at when he wants to know the health of the baby. And these get relayed onto a central monitoring station. So it's an IoT-enabled system. And we have all our processing and all the intelligence back in the cloud. Mm. So this is very lightweight in the sense that very minimal technology just to track the health of the newborn. And rest of it is our algorithms that run in the background to ensure that the baby is fine.
What organizations are you partnering with for clinical studies and where are they taking place?
So to start off, this work was funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation through the Grand Challenge Exploration Program. And it was followed up with funding from the Government of India, BIRAC, which supported us to develop the prototype and go forward towards studies. We're working with a leading hospital in South India and one government setup which is powered by UNICEF, which is more, it's called a specialized newborn care unit. There are two of them in the state of Hyderabad, in the state of Telangana, and we have two hospitals down south in Bangalore, which we use.
The NemoCare monitor, like, what's the current monitoring situation like and how does it improve on that?
So even in the best of setups that we have, so monitoring is only available in an ICU, neonatal ICU, where this prevents the baby from being brought to the mother's side for interventions like kangaroo mother care or breastfeeding. And it's only available in the top corporate hospitals and not even continuous monitoring. What we've done is make it baby friendly, designed for the baby, keeping it at the center of focus, and designed it in such a way that it can be stepped on, provide ICU grade monitoring at the bedside. So that's what we brought about. And our USP is also in the number of parameters we're monitoring from a single site, non-invasively. So that's the key factors that we are differentiating, monitoring, and also making it accessible and affordable using our innovative business models. Mm-hmm.
So you said that like one of the key differences is that right now babies who need that kind of monitoring, they can't be held or do skin to skin, but this enables that?
Yeah, because it's completely wireless, portable, and provides a high quality grade of monitoring. It can be used across the hospital setting today. Mm-hmm. That's where the focus is. And because we were targeting bottom of the pyramid, and prematurity is one of the causes, these are very important interventions. Skin to skin contact is very important, but today it's not possible because these babies need to be monitored for criticality. And the mother wouldn't even know if something happened to the baby. So with our device, we're trying to even track the progress, saying, give indicators to the mother saying this helped, the baby's vitals became better. So that's how we're bringing about positive behavioral change for such interventions.
So I know you mentioned the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, but yeah, I just wanted to know who your other investors and backers have been.
Sure, we started off with a grant, the Grand Challenges Exploration grant from the Gates Foundation, and that was $100,000. And then we went on to raise funds from a grant in aid from the Government of India initiative called BIRAC, which supports life science startups in India. Mm-hmm. And they've supported us over 2 years with different initiatives, helping us scale with not just a giving us financial aid, but also supporting us in terms of an ecosystem, in terms of regulatory and IP. And others have been the Center for Healthcare Entrepreneurship from IIT Hyderabad, where the founders were fellows from. Mm-hmm. So we've raised money from these sources, and most of it has been in terms of grants. Mm-hmm. And now we're looking to raise private equity to scale up the manufacturing more on the commercial side. And another reason why we were able to give this device at an affordable price is we developed it completely using grant and aid money. So that makes the cost of the device zero development at the time when we start shipping. So it's per unit cost that we'll have to recover when we're trying to be operationally profitable.
Okay, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.